Hello and welcome to The Big Picture. It's not unusual at all to witness tensions between the state and central government, especially when the two are ruled by different political parties. We have witnessed such tensions ever since independence, and I've also seen many state governments being dismissed for various reasons. However, what we are witnessing over a year, ever since the Aam Aadmi Party government took over in Delhi, is unusual to say the least. The tensions between the NDA government at the centre and the Aam Aadmi Party government is palpable on a daily basis. The differences is all-encompassing, be it about the use of Delhi police, the transfers and postings of officers, the passing of legislations and the necessary clearance from the centre. It's almost unprecedented that so many MLAs, 14 at the last count, all belonging to Aam Aadmi Party, having cases registered against them, out of whom 11 have been arrested and have spent varying times in police and judicial custody. Some MLAs have had income tax and other authorities visiting them. All this has resulted in Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal declaring that they are locked in a holy war with the centre and equating it to battle between Kauravas and Pandavas. Why have the relations between the Delhi government and the centre reached such damaging proportions? What are the reasons behind it? And how much of it is justified, and if there is any political vendetta involved. We will discuss all this today with Ved Marwah, former governor and also a Delhi police commissioner, Raghav Chaddha, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party, R.P. Singh, spokesperson of the BJP, Professor Anand Kumar will be joining us soon, Ashok Tandon, senior journalist, and Saba, Naqvi, also a senior journalist who has also authored a book on the Aam Aadmi Party and how it won Delhi elections. Welcome to all of you. Mr. Marwah, you have been a veteran, you have been watching these things for decades now. Do you think what we are witnessing now is the worst phase of central-state relations as far as Delhi is concerned?
It really saddens me because political differences one can understand. That's democracy is all about that. But using the type of language, falling down to this level, Particularly from a party which is led by a former civil servant. I think it's unbelievable. Something terribly wrong has happened. I think the root of the problem lies in the fact that Delhi, in fact, is not a full-fledged state. By projecting it as a full-fledged state and then demanding powers and responsibilities as other states have, create the basic problem. But even this is not a new problem. We've had this problem between all Delhi chief ministers and the central government. But even when in a party like Congress, but they developed a way of working in relationship where governors did not become a casualty. But today, the manner in which this political dialogue has been brought to this low level has made governance a casualty in Delhi and a great disillusionment for an ordinary citizen like me.
Okay. Raghav Chaddha, governance, would you agree with governance has become a casualty? As Mr. Marwah says, governance has become a casualty. And why has it been allowed to reach this kind of proportions?
Well, Girishji, to be honest, the Aam Aadmi Party government has been performing very well in Delhi. If you pick up our manifesto and if you try to corroborate every promise that we've made with the actions that you've seen over the last 1.5 years, you would find that many of those promises have been fulfilled and we are in the course of performing and delivering on the remaining ones. As far as
Raghav, sorry to intervene. No, I just have a small point. Your chief minister says that, you know, the way the center is intervening, he's not been able to function properly. You are saying that, you know, you have been performing perfectly.
No. The chief minister says, and if I quote him correctly, he says that we have performed very well over the last 1.5 years. But yes, if the Modi government does not, refrains from making moves to stall governance in Delhi, in that case, maybe our performance would have been four times or you know, would have been much better than we've already performed. So the fact is that the Aam Aadmi Party government in Delhi, and you can I'm not even asking you to take my word for it, you just pick up our manifesto, corroborate it with the actions that we have taken, the governance of the Aam Aadmi Party government in Delhi, and you will find that many of the promises have been made good, and the remaining ones are being fulfilled as we
then what is the problem?
But the fact is that there has been a systematic attempt by the central government to paralyze governance in Delhi. Every legislation that has been passed by the Delhi Legislative Assembly has either been withheld by the central government or been declined. The CBI was unleashed on the Chief Minister's office. The PMO, no less than the PMO, calls officers of the Delhi government, summons them and tells them that if you cooperate, if you play along with the ministers, or if you work with the ministers of the Aam Aadmi Party government, you will be booked under frivolous cases. The MHA on record writes a letter to the Chief Minister saying that you have no authority to appoint even your clerk or your stenographer. So an environment has been created in which governance in Delhi is being attempted to paralyze. They have made the Delhi Legislative Assembly ineffective by stalling every legislation, and such is the nature of the relationship of Delhi with the center. But they're also now attempting to paralyze governance, and also creating a fear among the bureaucracy. Every day a new MLA is booked, every day a new MLA is arrested, and on some days even two MLAs of the Aam Aadmi Party get arrested. If I were to quote figures to you, Girish ji, you would be surprised that out of the 78 ministers in this union cabinet headed by Shri Narendra Modi, there are 24 with serious criminal charges. Out of 282 members of parliament of the BJP, there are 98, that is 35%, which have serious criminal charges against them. No police, no CBI, no income tax department, no enforcement directorate ever acts against them. Suddenly the alacrity and the enthusiasm that we see in the Delhi police when it comes to acting against the Aam Aadmi Party MLAs. I think the people of India, the people of Delhi are extremely clever. Okay. They are seeing what the Bharatiya Janata Party is doing, and they are doing this only because they have never done this to a Congress government.
Okay.
They are doing this to us because they realize that if there is one formidable challenger that can challenge
Raghav,
that can challenge their corrupt communal
criminal
politics,
we will leave that aside. That's your interpretation. We leave that aside. Mr. R.P. Singh, what Raghav says, you know, the fact that the 14 MLAs have been arrested, On very flimsy grounds, I'm sure Mr. Marwah will bear with me, and you know he will I'll go to him for that. Why has there is this feeling that there is a political vendetta happening?
Okay, before I come to your point of what grounds their MLAs were booked, let me talk about the last where Mr. Raghav Chaddha left.
Yes.
He said corrupt. When there's cases of corruption one after one. And there's a case, there's an FIR being filed against the Chief Minister himself on corruption. On small ground, he asked his minister to quit. There was a case of one minister asking for a bribe. He handed over the file, he handed over the clip to the CBI and asked for an inquiry and made him quit. Then another case, he made Gopal Rai quit. Then another case, false degree case, I'm talking with the MLA now. And he was a minister also, he made him quit. Now there's an FIR filed against him, he's not quitting. As per criminal cases, as per he says, the criminal government. I mean, let's talk about the cases which have been launched against the ministers. Discretion of the Quran. Leasing dog on a pregnant wife. I mean, you want more? Land grabbing.
All these are...
These are cases filed not by us. By the wife of a minister. Not by us. So, how do you blame BJP for this? And also... I mean, land grabbing, not by us, but the person who... Give me a minute now.
Are you saying this has nothing to do with the government?
Give me a minute, sir. And he said communal government. I mean, they used the Granth Sahib on their manifesto and pasted the symbol on it. What can be bigger communalism than this? They discredited the Quran. What can be bigger communism than this? They said our manifesto is Guru Granth Sahib. What can be bigger communism than this?
No allegations, sir.
What are you talking about? Allegation? Can they deny the manifesto they published? Is it not an allegation?
Let me give him
complete time for a lecture. No. I never interrupted during when he was saying. No, please. And let me share with you. The problem of the root of the problem of the complete issue is in the DNA of the Aam Aadmi Party. And the DNA is anarchism. They don't believe in governance, they believe in anarchism. That's the problem.
No, okay. Raghav, would you like to respond quickly? No, not about the DNA. Yeah. We are not discussing
you
DNA.
See, though the comments made by the representative. Yes. No. Though the comments made by the spokesperson of the BJP don't even dignify. I don't even want to dignify that with the response. He certainly doesn't understand the difference between frivolous charges, allegations, investigation, prosecution, conviction. He is above all this. But the fact really is that if you go through the charges that have been leveled against our MLAs, and every day the newspapers have been printing all of them, and the observation of the court, in almost every case, the court has said that these are cases of political vendetta. In
okay.
some cases,
no,
the
I
court
don't think
has
Congress.
Also gone to the extent of saying
Jitendra
that
Singh
the
legalities
of state
second,
are being
Somnath
used
Bharti,
for
one Aklesh Pratap Tripathi, Naresh Yadav, Prakash Jorwa.
Clearly know how the BJP is operating. And I just want to conclude my statement by saying, that previously the Bharatiya Janata Party government, particularly the Prime Minister, was unleashing the Delhi police. Now they have unleashed the Punjab police, the CBI, the Income Tax Department,
okay.
and in the days
okay.
to come, we will see various central agencies going after the Aam Aadmi Party MLAs. We are prepared for it.
Okay, Raghav.
For the long run.
Okay, Raghav, fine.
We will
come back to you.
We will face every assault that these guys...
Raghav, one second.
Small rebut, sir. He will allow him to rebut. How about a case about that girl named Sony who was asked for a sexual favor by your MLA and his colleagues?
Not get into
and when she went to the chief minister, he said, make a compromise, do a compromise.
One second, Let us not get into this kind of thing, Mr. Ashok Tandon. Ashok Tandon, where do you think the problems lie? Where do you think, do you accept? You have also been a witness and, you have been witnessing for decades now. Do you think that it has reached a new low as far as inter-state relations are in Delhi is concerned?
Yeah, I first tend to agree with the sentiments expressed by Mr. Marwah, because he's a very experienced person. But I think we should not be discussing this issue in the context of wider scale of center-state relations, because Delhi is a union territory. But coming back to your point, I personally feel it is more a political rhetoric between the two political parties rather than any serious issue. Because elections are coming in Punjab and also perhaps the civic elections in Delhi. That is why the temperature is being raised by both the parties.
On an hour-to-hour basis, actually.
And that's why the language being used is more political rhetoric than there is substance in it, as Mr. Marwah has also explained, that Delhi has certain rules as union territory. And I'm sure Kejriwal and Raghav Chaddha, they know very well the limitations of governing a union territory, but because of the political rhetoric, they want to highlight certain issues that they are not being allowed to
But what about these arrests of the MLAs?
See, we have to go into the merit of it. In fact, we have a very senior IPS officer with us, but I personally feel the temperature which is being raised more so in the media is rather a political rhetoric than a real subject, which in fact Rajya Sabha TV should not be discussing at all.
Mr. Marwah, I'll come to you, Saba.
Well, my objection is not to the registration of cases and investigation of the cases. After all, it is the job of the police to do that. If there is a report of a cognizable offence having been committed, the police has to register a case and investigate it. My reservation is about arrests. In some of the cases, at least one gets the impression that, I don't know the facts, but general impression I get, perhaps the arrests could have been avoided.
Could have been avoided.
Without affecting the investigation of the case. And that is where the allegation that there is a political
vendetta
comes in.
Okay.
And that is not good for politics.
Absolutely.
In Delhi or anywhere else
anywhere
in
else.
The country.
Saba? Saba, where would you put the finger as far as the, where does the problem lie? Is it as somebody was pointing out here that, the powers and responsibilities, the fact that Delhi government doesn't, enjoy the same kind of powers as any other state, and the anxiety of the Aam Aadmi Party to acquire those powers. Is that where the problem lies?
To an extent, yes, Girish, but I want to say two, three things. And so just allow me uninterrupted to say it. it is so clear. We can go round and round and try and, you know, catch, you know, whatever. But it is so clear that the police does have instructions to go after them. Because in the case of so many cases against other parties, against other MLAs, the fact is we all know, no matter how wonderful our police may be, no matter, I'm not here to run down any section of society, but the fact is that if politicians do not wish to, certain cases are not pursued, as they are not uniformly pursued against members of the ruling party. I mean, look at the number of cases, serious cases against BJP leaders, which are not pursued. So obviously a signal has been given ki in logo ke piche jao. Now why has it been given? It's more than the fact that, I think it's a little bit more than the fact that Mr. Modi, the greatest humiliation he suffered after coming to power was in Delhi. Okay, in the Delhi election. Beyond that, that must be rankling a little bit. But beyond that, I think there's another point about Aam Aadmi Party. The problem is they're out of the traditional political system. They came in making enemies with the bureaucracy, with everyone, okay? With the corporate class, everyone. They are an anti-system force who is now trying to run the system. So that creates its own problems. There's a very serious dimension to harassing an elected party. And actually, in a traditional format, had they been a traditional political party, they would have got much more support across the political board. They are not getting that from other colleagues, non-BJP colleagues. They're not getting that. I think only Mamata Banerjee has made a statement about it, because fundamentally, when the Congress did it and when the BJP does it today, it is an encroachment of rights. You can go on about technicalities of statehood. I mean, these are things which erode our systems, which erode the fact. I mean, you can go on splitting hairs about union territory and all of this. Fair enough. Everybody has a right to overreach their power. I mean, everybody wants to be, you know, stronger than they are. I mean, you know, and if you recall, Mr. Modi, when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat, famously said that the Congress had given a supari to the BJP to go after him. So this kind of strong rhetoric is used by mass leaders. And at the very least, we can concede that Mr. Kejriwal may have won a union territory, but he has become a mass leader in a very short time. So there are three, four things involved in this. They've gone after the most powerful corporates in India. So the system fundamentally doesn't like them, okay? But they've been elected with a huge mandate, and currently they are growing. From all accounts, they're growing in Punjab. And it's just so, it's so clear. I mean, how is there any debate that they are being hounded, none of their laws are being passed. Everything okay. that they try and do, there okay. is something which tries to block it. You okay. know, it's very clear.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Singh.
Very small comment. And Saba, do you know that all the laws, all the bills they have passed, out of which bills are basically salary bills? And there's a...
I can't hear.
Okay, there is a system for a bill to be approved.
I can't hear you, whoever's talking.
Saba, this is R.P. Singh, your old friend. And I'm telling you, for every bill which they pass, there's
yeah,
a way.
Is it
a financial bill? Then it is be routed through a proper process. They have tried to surpass their processes. That's the problem. And I have the complete list of the 14 bills. If you want, I'll send you the complete details of the 14. I'm not reading them here. I'll send it to Saba.
Okay.
But Saba, another issue. I'm sorry. You talk about a mass leader. After
I couldn't hear what RP is saying.
Okay, no, after the last election, last assembly election, when they ran away from Delhi, they went and contested the complete country.
Okay.
And they lost on all
seats. Okay, that is not the...
We are not discussing that.
That's her point of view, that he's a mass leader. Mr. Singh, you don't have to worry about it. Yes, Chaddha. Raghav.
Let us please draw a distinction between the topic of the debate and certain experts commenting on the technicalities of Delhi being a union territory. The constitution is very clear. Law and order, police and land are not within the ambit of a democratically elected government of Delhi, and that is also not the topic of the debate. The topic of the debate is that how state instrumentalities are being misused for political purposes. This is exactly the model followed by Shri Narendra Modi when he was the Chief Minister of Gujarat. He went after each and every political adversary. He let loose his CBI, his CID, the anti-corruption branch, the police, etc. And all of us have witnessed the kind of atrocities that his political adversaries faced in Gujarat because of this approach. The fact really is that the Bharatiya Janata Party, the current leadership of the BJP, Mr. Modi and Amit Shah, they do not believe in the fundamentals of democracy. Look at what they've done in Uttarakhand. Look at what they've done in Arunachal. They're similarly trying to attempt to paralyze governance in Delhi.
Okay, Raghav, I have a question. The question is that, you know, the way your chief minister conducts himself, there is a certain amount of, you know, some people even call it some kind of a persecution complex which he suffers from. He wants to show that, you know, he's always under attack. You know, is there a problem there? And also, why isn't, after more than a year, that he has not been, your government has not been able to come to some kind of an understanding to run the government in according to the constitution? Because what you're asking is more than what the constitution gives you.
It's 2 years now.
Okay, which action of Arvind Kejriwal's government do you classify as unconstitutional, Mr. Nikam? And my question is to you.
No, some of the powers which you are demanding, like the police, you want the police powers, constantly you are having problems with the police. Constantly you are having problems with certain appointments which have to go through the center.
There are certain legislations which have to go through the center which you are not going through.
These have all been issues which have been discussed.
You're a very senior journalist. I certainly expect you to not make such off-the-cuff statements or sweeping
statements. We have been discussing this for the last two years.
I challenge you to point out one procedure adopted by the government of NCT of Delhi that is unconstitutional. I challenge you to point out one action of the government of Delhi that can even remotely be classified as unconstitutional. Yes, we have said that Delhi police, law and order and land should be under the ambit of the democratically elected government of Delhi. But that is only a demand. And we have also said that we will struggle to get full statehood to Delhi. That is precisely what the BJP and the Congress have also mentioned in the manifesto. But the fact really is that the problem between the center and the state, the problem between Delhi and the union government is much beyond law and order, police and land. The problem is that Mr. Modi has decided to completely sabotage governance in Delhi, to sabotage the Aam Aadmi Party, and he has unleashed every agency under his control.
Let me get R.P. Singh on this. Yes, Mr. Singh.
I'm giving you a challenge, Mr. Raghav. A very brief. I mean, here's a complete manifesto of yours, all 70 points. And I'm prepared to, let's have a long debate. I'm prepared to debate each one of them. You're not fulfilled a single. And that's the problem
today.
We're
not talking of fulfillment.
No.
He's saying that nothing unconstitutional has been done.
That's the problem. The problem is that since they're not able to fulfill any of their promises, and they have fallen flat on all promises, that's why he keeps doing this. Mr. Kejriwal, keep playing the victim card. And yes, on all his bills, I'm saying, all 14 bills are here. And all there are reasons because they are not passed through a proper system. And if you want, let's have a separate debate on each bill.
Okay.
I'll discuss each bill.
We will have a separate debate on that.
Flat on it.
Please tell me. Please point out.
I challenge the BJP spokesperson
and I challenge Girish ji, you two also, point out one fallacy.
Prepare for a debate on all 14 bills.
One second, Raghav. We are now joined in by Prof. Anand Kumar, president of the Swaraj Abhiyan, who was formerly with the Aam Aadmi Party. Professor Anand Kumar, we have got very little time left now. The question is that, why do you think that the relations between the centre and the state government and the government of Delhi has deteriorated to this extent?
It looks that the present central government has little respect for dissenters and parties which do not go with the NDA line of politics and policy making. So from Uttarakhand and Arunachal to Delhi, there is one script. But in case of Delhi, there is also a trajectory of victimhood. The government of Delhi has less to show on its credit card about the things which are related with their very beautiful poll promises. Now to go as far as claiming that even murder of the chief minister can be taking place in near future, and some kind of a dharma yudh is on, is really misuse of media and abuse of political culture. You have freedom of saying a few things, but they should be substantiated. If there is a threat to life, to the Chief Minister of Delhi by the Prime Minister of India, it is not cooperative federalism. And both sides owe a lot to the people of India. If they are making jokes, if they are abusing their constitutional authority, then it's a very sad politics.
So you think that this is just rhetorics which are happening? Ashok Tandon thinks that, you know, these are election time rhetorics.
I don't know whether it is election time rhetoric or not, but I must say that hyperbolic positions, politics goes by understatement. Particularly the elected people should be speaking more by their activities than by abusing media and the possibility of grabbing headlines. And in case of Aam Aadmi Party, they have been attracting consistently the headlines, but for wrong reasons.
Okay.
They must go for course correction.
Okay, Mr. Tandon.
Can I just...
I'll come to you, Saba.
See, I initially said that Rajya Sabha TV is not the forum to discuss the local politics of Delhi.
This is not local. It has become larger than local.
Girish,
Delhi is very much, you know, in the focus.
That is the most unfortunate part of it is that in Delhi, which is the seat of power of the central government, this kind of rhetoric is taking place. I agree with Professor Anand that people who have been elected, they should perform. Rather than indulging in rhetoric all the time, trying to engage the Prime Minister of India. You know, we all know very well what is the constitutional position of the Delhi government and its Chief Minister. So all the time trying to engage himself with the Prime Minister as if he has a political agenda to expand his base. So I don't think the kind of role which the elected Chief Minister of Delhi should have been playing, I agree with Professor Anand. He has not enough to show.
Okay.
That is why perhaps the rhetoric.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Marwah.
You know, the Aam Aadmi government, when it came to power, it made certain promises which made it get that sort of a mandate, an unparalleled mandate. One of them was that they remove corruption.
Yes.
Now, let me give you my own experience. I had to get a rent deed registered and I went to the registration office, which is entirely under the Delhi government. And I sat there for 2 hours. They demanded money. I said, I'm getting registration done. I didn't pay in that heat. I was there for 2 hours. And ultimately, a middleman came. I said, Baba, you get it done. I can't get it done.
Raghav, it's a very serious charge.
There's a true story.
Somebody like Mr. Marwah, you know, it's a very serious problem. Very quickly,
you knew my background and everything, but they were not bothered.
One instance, but pertaining to a particular department.
Of his own experience,
pointed out, if his yes,
how
if
can
he's,
a chief minister who is involved in corruption can control it?
An incident in which there has been a department. I will certainly make note of this and forward it to my colleagues. In the party. But the fact really is that Mr. Marwah must also, I'm sure, is aware of the fact that the anti-corruption branch of the government of Delhi, the agency which is responsible to curb corruption in Delhi, was captured by Shri Narendra Modi by sending paramilitary forces. Like the office of the ACB was physically captured by sending paramilitary forces. And since that
since July 2015,
the anti-corruption branch of the government of Delhi does not report to us. It works as per the whims and fancies of the Prime Minister's office.
Okay, I think
that's point number one.
Okay.
Point number two, I am astonished as to how there are a couple of panelists who do not...
Please complete.
No, all I'm trying to say is that I am, while there are certain people on the panel who have, you know, are not very appreciable or do not really appreciate the actions or the governance that has been shown by the Aam Aadmi Party or the government of Delhi. That they must also see how police and various agencies have been misused by Mr. Modi to target Aam Aadmi Party MLAs, to office bearers of the Aam Aadmi Party.
Raghav, please. Yes, Sabha, very quickly, we're completely run out of time.
You know, very quickly, I want to pick up one thing that Professor Anand said. He says political rhetoric, broadly he was saying people should not be making such a noise. But I think you know this, Girish. Our political culture has changed. It is BJP that started this, having covered the party for years. They were great at just having rhetoric and doing it. Now you have a very, very small party which is able to engage the national media. So in a sense, they are being attacked by the police, they are even the media, sections of it, the whole system is after them. But please remember, the BJP strategists, they are getting traction every day because they are making sure they are also in the news. And you are making it possible for them by not allowing them to work quietly, by going after them.
Okay.
So this whole culture of rhetoric, just look at the speeches of the people who are now in power.
Okay.
Look at the culture of getting attention through rhetoric and going after famous people.
Saba, you made a point.
I think on that note,
we need to end. It is not a very savory situation what we are witnessing. Hopefully, this rhetoric will give way to some sobriety in the atmosphere. Thanks to all my guests. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue in the big picture, same time tomorrow.